Onshape is introducing several new ways to create geometry with the introduction of end conditions for revolved features. This provides new ways to define how your revolve features terminate. For example, you can choose up to next to simply terminate when the profile intersects with the next available existing geometry. Up to part allows you to specify an entire part or body, and then the revolve profile will fully terminate into that part. You can, of course, choose to merge the separate parts if needed. Up to vertex allows you to select any point. This could be geometry found in a layout sketch, for example, or simply be any vertex on your components as well. Finally, up to face allows you to specify any type of face. This could actually be the face of a plane, but in many cases, you'll probably want to choose one of the faces of your designed part. These new end conditions for the revolve feature simplify the design process by eliminating the need for calculating angles or the need to remove geometry after the feature is created. While sketching in Onshape, you may want to enable or disable the display of sketch settings like equations and constraints. In the past, these options would have to be enabled each time you edited a sketch. Now, these sketch settings are sticky and will persist on a per-user basis. This persistence will be honored across documents and sessions, meaning you can choose the setting you prefer and Onshape will remember them until you decide to change them. Disable imprinting will not change any existing sketches, but default to the last choice you made for any new sketches that are created. This greatly improves the overall usability of these sketch settings. The Sketch Slot tool now allows you to use closed profiles like circles for their creation. This also includes the ability to include complex closed spline profiles like those used to define the gasket groove on this pump housing. This provides more flexibility in how you can create your geometry in Onshape.
Want to check the quality of your surface connections? This new tool, Connection Analysis, evaluates continuity between edges and between faces and edges. G0 for position, G1 for tangency, and G2 for curvature, helping you ensure smooth, high-quality transitions for your surfaces. Visual feedback with intuitive color coding makes it easy to identify issues and confirm that your design meets the required standards. Whether you're building high-end surfaces or just curious, Connection Analysis ensures precision and confidence in your workflow.
In this release, Onshape's powerful in-context modeling has been further enhanced. This tablet stand can be positioned at one of three different angles, which have been captured using named positions. Critically though, the geometry of the notches in the black support leg are actually driven by the position, a perfect use case of Onshape's managed in-context design. A separate context has been defined, creating each notch. The challenge, however, is whenever the position of the tablet stand is moved for any reason at all, each of the contexts shows a potential update, even though one is not necessarily required. Editing the part in context, though, you can now set a context to follow a named position. We'll quickly do this for each of the three contexts we created, linking it to the appropriate named position, which was used to create that specific notch. Returning to the assembly, notice that simply moving the assembly through its range of motion does not trigger a potential context update. This is because the named positions are now driving the contexts, not the current assembly position. This time, however, we will edit the named position of upright and just adjust the orientation of the model slightly. In doing so, notice that only the context that is associated with that named position is marked with an opportunity to update. This context can easily be updated from the Part Studio or by simply selecting Update Context directly from the assembly. This powerful linking capability can be freely adjusted at any time to suit your needs. It allows you clearer control of updates on multiple contexts, especially in assemblies where verifying motion is an ongoing requirement.
Assembly Mirror provides a powerful way to create opposite hand versions of your parts. When creating the feature, you're given the choice whether or not you want to simply transform the parts being mirrored or derive them into new opposite hand versions. In this release of Onshape, when mirroring sheet metal components, Onshape now also provides a flat pattern for those new derived sheet metal parts. This ensures all of the manufacturing information is immediately available and eliminates the need to reference the original part's flat pattern. Configuration visibility conditions have enabled you to add customization, flexibility, and control to your configured designs. Sometimes, the ability to add multiple visibility conditions to a configuration table can lead to complex configurations. In these cases, you may want to simply state that a configuration option is always available. New for this release of Onshape, you can now specify that options are simply always shown regardless of any other visibility conditions that have been created. This eliminates complexity and confusion when building your configurations in Onshape. Onshape now enables you to use CSV files to drive the variables in your designs. These can be created from a variety of sources, like a spreadsheet application. To reference the CSV file, start creating a variable like you normally would. Here, you will notice a new creation tab at the top of the dialog, From Table. This new tab has many new parameters. Most notably, you can select a CSV file. If none exists within the current document, you can choose to import one here also. For the first value, we will use the By Index selection and choose the second row using an index of 1. For the column selection, we want the second column, so again an index of 1 is entered. As soon as we select a cell containing a value, the variable will present this value in the feature list. For the second variable, we can now select the CSV file directly from the document, since it was previously imported. This time, we will select the row using the By Label choice. For this input, we can use the values from the first column to select the desired row. For the column, an index of 1 will be used again to select the column containing the values. And like before, once a valid cell has been selected, its value will appear on the variable in the feature list. For the third and final variable, like before, the CSV file will be selected and the variable named. The row again will be selected using the value from the first column. This time, however, the value from the third column will be selected, which is defined in inches, not millimeters, which our document has been designed in up to this point. Here, you can enable the use of a conversion factor to modify the value. In this case, to resolve the value in millimeters, a multiplication of 25.4 is entered. Notice the value on the variable changes immediately to reflect this in the feature list. Once the variables are created, they can be used just like any other variable. In the case of this stator design, these three values will be used to further refine the initial sketch by entering their names into the existing dimensions, changing their values to match their associated variables. The ability to reference CSV files to drive your designs opens up completely new possibilities for your parametrically driven designs. In our last release cycle, Onshape introduced load-on-demand graphical refinement. Continuing to build on that technology, this release now improves load-on-demand to also refine transparent component graphics within your designs. This continues to improve overall performance and responsiveness when using Onshape.
Here's an exciting update for all you CAM Studio users. We're expanding access to the adaptive options. You'll now find adaptive cutting options for 2D roughing, 3D roughing, and flatlands. These adaptive strategies maintain a constant chip load, which improves accuracy, shortens cycle times, and delivers smoother, more efficient machining. Additionally, it can extend tool life by evenly distributing wear along the cutting edge, and it can reduce wear on machines by minimizing heavy cuts. Give it a try in your next setup. Work planes and datums have been added to CAM Studio. This new set of features enables users to define datums or work coordinate systems without the need of a new setup. When creating a job, the setup defines the initial work plane. Each datum created afterwards within the setup can either reference this initial datum or automatically assign the next available. When the new work coordinate system is needed, users can now select the Create Work Plane icon to define the new datum. Once the position has been selected, users can choose from the following options. Absolute will automatically assign the next available identifier, or the user has the option to override and choose a specific identifier. The None option will default to the initial work plane and will be expanded on in future releases. Once posted, the work coordinate system identifier can be seen in the program as defined in the CAM system. This powerful addition to CAM Studio is the first step in building the robust framework for multi-part machining setups and multi-axis support. Datum overrides have been added to CAM Studio to allow users full control over assigning work coordinate system identifiers. Users can now apply a unique identifier for each setup or work plane created. With this update, users can now manually shift a work coordinate system location using X, Y, and Z values. If a user needs to assign a work coordinate system on a specific feature or a specific location, users can measure in the Part Studio and apply those values in CAM Studio. Introducing a smarter way to manage workholding in Onshape CAM Studio. With the new Workholding tab found at Job Creation, you can now assign specific features to each job, so your simulations show only what matters. Recently, tool hand attributes were added to CAM Studio. With these changes, the post framework has been updated to automatically recognize these attributes for milling, drilling, and tapping operations. Enjoy more reliable, intuitive CAM workflows with these powerful updates.